It's time to wake up. Welcome to the future. Good morning, good morning, good morning. I forgot to have the microphone on. I didn't turn the microphone on. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to LVG. I haven't streamed in a while. Really want to play this game. I've only done chapter one. I don't see a chat box here. I'm trying to find a chat box menu for this. So, let's see if I can get that situated. I don't remember if there was a way to do it. This window's away. Anyway, I'm gonna find this chat box real quick. Actually, and then I'll start the game. Oh, Nathaniel, you're here. Okay, cool. What's up? It was all right. Thanksgiving was okay. How was your Thanksgiving? All right, cool. So I got you. You just tested my chat box first. Next is an audio check. Okay. Hey, I'm start playing a game and see what goes on. Can you hear me, Nathaniel? How's the... I don't know if you can hear my voice, but... Okay, let's get back into the game.
Time to tie half a sentence on the caseboard.
Oh.
But he's still caught up. The page predicted all of it. It helped me fight him.
Just disappeared? What the hell is...
Sorry. I'm gonna fix this little camera thing. That's much better.
What's going on here?
We need to figure that out if we're gonna do anything about it. Somehow we need to make sense of this. There is no rational explanation to what we just saw.
I'd love to blame this on mass hallucination caused by inhaling volcanic gas, but we both know that's bullshit. This was supernatural.
Well, I'm glad you were the one to say it. Now we can figure out a way forward. The victim of a ritualistic murder turns into a monster. Is there a connection?
Looks to me like the cult of the tree is performing rituals to create monsters.
Maybe. We need to start with learning this cult's goal, their purpose. Right before things got crazy, Sheriff Breaker just vanished.
Maybe the sheriff knew more than he was letting on.
He seemed anxious, like he dreaded what was coming. One more mystery.
Look around for clues.
There's one of the pages on the floor.
Saga was back at Cauldron Lake. Saga had to pursue Nightingale into the overlap. Finding a way in would be difficult. A ritual. Saga would learn how. Stop the monster.
Excuse me for the bad cough, guys.
Must be locked from the other side.
This is my... what is it, her safe haven? Her mind? It's pretty cool. I need to complete this case. If I can remember how to do it.
The killers are usually the ones performing the ritual, not the detective. Acting out their sick fantasy. They may be trying to get you involved, forcing you into their twisted world. The killers are usually the ones performing the ritual, not the detective. Acting out their sick fan.
Any more evidence? Don't remember. Okay. Figure out where Nightingale went. Let's check out the profile.
Saga was back at Cauldron Lake. He was there too. Nightingale was, but wasn't a Taken, a creature of darkness. He was beyond her reach. Where some other strange reality, the Dark Place, merged with ours. This place and the Dark Place, a tarp thrown over top, drowning everything beneath it, a flood of darkness, soaking into everything, spoiling it, rotting it. The page called this area an overlap. Saga had to pursue Nightingale into the overlap. Finding a way in would be difficult, required precise steps, a ritual. Saga would learn how. Stop the monster before he killed again. Her job, he'd be inside, waiting for her.
Okay. Ooh, weapon upgrades.
Casey's favorite brand. Tastes terrible.
I'm broke. I know I was supposed to do something here. Oh, there it goes.
A dead man turned into a monster. Light as a way to fight him. Pages predicting the future. There's no rational explanation. This is the case we must solve. Yes.
One more time.
The page places Nightingale back at Cauldron Lake. Calls him a Taken. We need to head over there, stop him, before anyone else gets hurt.
Okay.
We heard gunshots. Y'all okay?
Did you get spooked by the bodies?
Sheriff Breaker disappeared. Nightingale turned into some sort of a monster, and there are offices down. You two handle things here. We need to get back to Cauldron Lake immediately.
Fuck me. That's terrible. We'll do what we can, man.
But that's crazy, right, Thornton? Nightingale's heart was missing. How could he do anything? Dead.
Yeah, right.
I need bolt cutters.
Crazy talk. Monsters aren't real. Magic's not real.
My client has been held here long enough. Are you gonna let me speak to them or not?
Just a moment, ma'am. Someone will be right with you.
I can't force it open.
How many times do we have to do this,
Walter?
I want
out! Something bad's going down!
My wit's
end. I can feel it! Let me out!
Do you think I like throwing you in jail?
Nightingale and his cult are dangerous. We need to be prepared in case things escalate more than they already have. Can you call it in, Casey?
A smart choice, Anderson. Agent Casey here. Yeah. We need backup. The Bright Falls case. Whoever you can spare. ASAP. Think we'll actually find Nightingale at the lake?
The pages haven't been wrong yet.
We can't assume the person writing these pages isn't playing us.
I agree. But it's our best lead.
Rinse and repeat. Clock out, get a beer. Or maybe three.
I need to come clean, Anderson.
No.
I know why Nightingale was here 13 years ago. He was chasing a writer, Alan Wake.
Tammy mentioned him. She's writing a book on his disappearance.
You know the detective character from his books, Alex Casey.
Yeah, I've heard the jokes at the office. Cold Case Casey.
Murder Case Casey. Sorry.
Ha ha. The same name, similar job. It's the first thing anyone thinks of. It annoyed me, but that was it. Then, 10 years ago, I started getting strange letters in the mail. Fragments of prose describing murders. You've heard the stories about what happened in New York. Some of it, at least. Bodies started to pile up. It was a murder cult. Turns out the fragments sent to me were from the crime books of Alan Wake. The cult was copycatting the murders from the books. In their heads, they were performing a ritual to bring Wake back. Their imagined prophet. After that case, I started looking into Wake's disappearance on the side.
And you thought this case might be connected to him? His name does keep popping up.
Well said.
I just wanted you to have all the facts.
Next time, give them to me before we find ourselves in the middle of a horror story.
Hold on, guys. I'll be right back. I'm gonna eat real quick. Okay, I'm back. Sorry about that. I don't know if anyone's still there, but... Where were we?
The page says Nightingale's in something called an overlap. Need to figure out exactly what that means.
I'm happy I'm not in charge of this mess.
Thanks. Let's start looking for Nightingale where he was killed.
Let's increase that FPS. If we can try. This will make a difference, but this is a pretty demanding game, isn't it?
Great. This area is supposed to be close to the public. The writer of these pages knows what will happen. Because they're behind this, or because they can see what's coming. Impossible things are happening here. A world operating on different rules. I need to understand this strange logic. To see the clues. To solve the case.
Why is my face doing this? My camera can't make up its mind.
I've been thinking more about the cult of the tree. What sort of cult refers to themselves as a cult?
In my experience, they don't.
We're not seeing the full picture yet.
Hey, hello there. How are you folks doing?
Those restricted area signs don't do a damn thing, huh?
Hello. Saga Anderson. Are you two supposed to be here?
I'm Ilmo Koskela. Fantastic to meet you. And yes, Stephen here hired me to show him through the woods. He's in town on important government business. Fixing this impressive piece of hardware.
I work for the FBC, ma'am. I'm authorized to be here.
And I bet you two are here about that murder. Nasty stuff. How's it going?
How did you hear about the murder, Ilmo? Do you know anything that could help us?
People tend to tell me things. The Koskela brothers are kind of a household name around here. Speaking of, if you're looking for some fun, stop by Watery. Just down the road from Bright Falls, there's our Coffee World amusement park. There's Sauna de Vista. And we offer a variety of guided tours, hunting, fishing, hiking, whatever strikes your fancy. You name it, we probably got it.
What is this thing?
It's just a monitoring station, ma'am. The Federal Bureau of Control checks volcanic activity and air toxicity levels. No need to worry, though. It's mostly for research purposes.
That's one gorgeous weather saga. Looks Nordic. I bet a family member made it.
My mother made this sweater for me. How do you know?
I knew it. My mom used to knit those sweaters for me and my brother. Watery, my hometown, was founded by Finnish immigrants. So between your name and the sweater, I figured your family might be from Finland too. Suomi, Finland. Pulla, Karjalan piirakka.
Close. My mom's family is from Sweden originally. I don't know much about them beyond that. The sweater is just something to remember her by. Stephen, we're investigating a murder that occurred nearby. What can you tell me about your bureau?
Nothing that isn't classified, I'm afraid. But I don't know anything about a murder. Operations here are run by a different department. I'm just here to make some repairs. The wiring on this thing frays every couple months.
Yep, that's the raccoons. They grow real big here with teeth like you wouldn't believe. Can't gnaw right through a garbage can.
That's all I've got for the moment.
We brew our own beer, too.
Let's get to the murder site, Casey.
Now we're talking.
A lot of things about this case keep bothering me. But one thing feels really off. Breaker's disappearance. I don't get the feeling Nightingale was responsible.
He was about to give you more of those pages. Something didn't want us to have them? Or was protecting him from Nightingale? Spontaneous combustion? I don't know. Not the kind of disappearance we normally solve. Our crime scene's drowning. I never minded rain. Feels like home.
No sign of Nightingale. But the page did place him at Cauldron Lake in an overlap. So how do we follow him there?
Maybe something around here will tell us.
We've seen this symbol before.
Could I?
Bare feet. Nightingale. I'll see where these footprints lead. Can you comb through the crime scene one more time, KC? Just in case?
On it. If anything comes up, I'll radio you.
A lunchbox again. Who's leaving these out here? The tracks lead into the water. Where'd you go from here?
Oh, god dang.
I can feel something. A presence. Nightingale isn't far.
I hate jump scares.
What is that? Seems like it's reacting to the light. These aren't the same tracks that were here before. They're headed into the tree, not out of it. My flashlight burned the dark stuff away. It was covering another page.
The fuse was in place. Saga stepped into the witch's hut. Inside, a bright light. There were objects that stood out to Saga, as if the light had manifested them.
The witch's hut. Okay. I trust the pages to lead me to the overlap.
Safe haven. Return.
The fuse was in place. She found it among the junk in the forest.
Alright, now we don't need to listen to that again.
No.
I'm trying.
Makes sense. Light is the key to stay safe, but for something more to be revealed as well.
To go where? Locate the witch's hut. Get the lights working in the witch's hut. Locate a fuse in the immediate area. Alright. This. Jesus. Alright. Alright, so locate. Go to the witch's hut. Yeah, it's fine. Let's do it.
I need to find the witch's hut. This is the witch's hut.
Anderson, I thought I saw something in the woods. Probably just a deer, but I'm gonna check it out.
Okay. I found another page. Following up on a lead. Keep checking in.
Roger.
The fuse box is missing a fuse. I need to find one to turn on the lights. The page described the hut being lit and mentioned a fuse.
No fuse.
This fuse is busted. This one looks good. People should really stop littering, though.
Break room's a place where you can save your progress. Really? Oh, I can finally save a game. After doing one chapter. Jeez. My first save. How amazing.
Another page. Making progress.
The image of the witch in the sign. Saga addressed the witch. The smudged line on the heart. The second part recited from memory. I brought you the heart, witch. Show me the terror. Saga pushed the heart through the hole in the sign.
The witch's sign. So I need to go back down. Is there any way I can... I can't... I have to actually go and find it, like, Silent Hill style.
The page from the witch's hut seems to be describing some kind of ritual. To get into the overlap, I need to find Nightingale's heart. Read the line imprinted on it, plus the line on the page to the witch's ladle sign. Then push the heart through the hole in the sign.
Nightingale's heart disappeared from the morgue. Where is it now? I know Nightingale is somewhere around Cauldron Lake.
The tree was a threshold. This place and the dark place. You're in over your head. Next stop, Caldera Street Station.
The threshold, like a doorway, leading to Nightingale. It's somehow connected to a tree. Which is Ladle? I need Nightingale's heart to get to the overlap. Where is it?
The cultist leaned close. He was there, but he was risen. Nightingale was there. The opposite of sunspots. Who said that?
That's not it. I don't have what I need to find Nightingale's heart. There must be more. Nightingale's heart. Where is it?
Meanwhile, they played cards in the general store. The witch had stolen his heart. Get out of my house.
Nightingale's heart is at the general store, in a fridge. I need to check the general store for the heart.
Casey, I'm headed to the general store. I think I know how to get into the overlap.
Roger that. I followed some ATV tracks in the woods and got a bit turned around.
Did you get lost?
I've only been lost once in my life, Anderson. The years I spent with my ex-wife. I'll find my way back, don't you worry about it.
Did I go back for no reason? Perform the ritual to open overlap. FBC station. point of interest. Oh no, I gotta go backwards. How did I miss that? This is why you pay attention to the maps. Come on, load. Okay, so I gotta zigzag it. So, down, right, left. Okay. Make sure I'm going the right way. Oh. It's just a deer.
Text on the heart is clearer now. Legible. I feel like I recognize this. The fridge. The heart. I knew it would be here. Like I saw it in a dream. And now I need to give the heart to the witch. Makes total sense. Casey.
Yeah, thanks for the heads up. I'm still finding my way back. Any city in America I can get through drunk and blindfolded. It's these damn trees.
Okay. I'm en route to Witch's Ladle. I need to perform a ritual to open the overlap. This case just keeps getting weirder. But it is exciting.
Okay. So go back. I need more health.
The wave crashed on the far side of the mirror. I brought you the Heart Witch. Show me the terror.
I think I'm in the overlap. Are you still on your way? Casey! Casey, do you read me?
Fuck. Okay, Saga. Going in solo. Logan?
Mom, help.
Logan! Where are you? What the fuck was that? Logan's back in Virginia. You're imagining things.
Lost. I just came from here, right?
Would you please help me?
What was that? Wait. Did I get turned around? No, this is right. This place is looping. Like a nightmare. Need to find Nightingale.
Saga edged toward the broken door, her gun ready, flashlight aimed ahead. Nightingale said it would be here. The Cauldron Lake General Store was overgrown, left to rot. Saga thought about the Cult of the Tree. They had been here, waiting, planning a gruesome ritual murder. Meanwhile, they played cards in the general store, like it was just another late-night poker game. Saga stepped closer to the door. Had the animal broken it? There was a loud crash. Saga found herself face to face with a cultist, a hulking figure in a raincoat. We watch in the night, wild eyes behind a plastic deer mask, an axe in his raised hand.
Nice. Hold on, guys.